My informal answer is all three are similar, and it is about someone trying to attack and gather information from you in different manners. Thus the phishing, vishing, and smishing. So phishing is when they usually do it through an email. Vishing is when they do it through phone calls. And then smishing is through text messages.
Yeah. I know we all see the email from the post office saying your package couldn't be delivered. Call this number. Yeah.
Call this number.
That's a smishing.
Mm-hmm. Or my favorite one is when you get the call from Microsoft that you have a virus on your computer.
Oh, yeah.
Someone just straight calls you and, you know, hey, you need to let us in your computer to clear it up and you need to buy the software.
Yep.
Now, obviously, Microsoft doesn't call you to tell you that information, so.
No.
So true, so true. And nowadays, it's gotten harder and harder to differentiate a lot of that information. And they can mimic, especially on the vishing part, they can mimic it being a local number. Years ago, it used to be, you know, you kind of knew where you were or where it was coming from with the area codes and things like that. Now they really can be coming from anywhere over the world, and it will may pop up with a local area code. And it's just another way of trying to get you to participate in something you really have no business participating in.
Absolutely. And the big kicker is nowadays the smishing has become way more prevalent, and it's much harder to catch. So we all know that phishing can be caught by checking the URL you're going to or who it's coming from. But smishing, they just send you a text and it may look real. Hey, here's a Kohl's discount, click here. And it's harder to identify them, so it's getting a lot more people now.
Yeah, and part of that is because, you know, you may have a Kohl's account, mm-hmm. but they may also know that. So they know that's a quicker way of being able to get you to yep. click on something that really and truly has nothing to do with Kohl's. One that just happened to me recently, and thank goodness I did not click on it, but it was a vishing and phishing. And it was due to a conference, and it was a major conference that happens every year, well-known conference, and people have figured out, the bad actors have figured out, that's a way to try to get in to say, oh, I can give you a discount on a room, and oh, they're working with us, blah, blah, blah. And so you just have to be very diligent on making sure that you're not giving away your credit card information to supposedly save $25 on a hotel room when that's really and truly not gonna be the case when you get there. But there are ways of being able to combat it, you know, especially when it comes to email. And making sure that you're doing the proper things there. What do y'all see when y'all are talking to our clients about their email?
I think the most prevalent thing we see is probably training. They need to do a lot more training. You know, it's sort of like when I was in the military, you train like you fight. Otherwise, when it happens, you don't notice it. So if you train more often about phishing attacks and seeing sample phishing attacks, you're more apt to see one when it's really happening.
Mm-hmm. That's right. And part of the training just raises that awareness, right? And using the correct tools, some anti-phishing tools, while they don't catch everything, they're really good at adding just that extra layer of defense around that to help you with the process.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
And I would just say, stay diligent, because we've talked about three, you know, smishing, vishing, and phishing. This is everything. There's not just these three. I mean, they could send you a mail to your house saying, hey, you owe this bill, call this number. It's the same thing. It's just a matter of how long they have to wait, you know, and we know it's on social media galore. Look at Snapchat. If you're on Snapchat, you get them all the time. Hey, friend me, look at my page, you know, so. It's everywhere. So yes. Just be diligent and make sure things you asked for is what you're doing, and you know what you're doing is what you wanted to do.